measuring PIP and DIP extension. The patient will be in a seated or comfortable position. But also with this, the hand, it can be resting on its side on the table, it can be up in this position, it can be any position you want to, but whatever position you have the patient in, make sure that the fingers are not resting against an object to promote more extension than they actually have. So you want to be careful about that. So when measuring extension, it will be identical to measuring PIP and DIP flexion. The same process will happen. So you will have your stationary arm of your goniometer on the proximal phalanx, your movement arm on the middle phalanx, and the axis on the PIP joint. So Rachel, what I want you to do for me is I want you to pretend like you cannot extend your fingers very far. Yeah, just about right there, yeah. So I'm gonna put it on the proximal phalanx, middle phalanx, and the axis over the joint. Now, normally, she should be able to extend her finger to full extension, which is up here, right? So what we want to do is we want to see how big this gap is. So I'm going to bring down my movement arm and see how many degrees she's lacking. So right here, we're looking at 65 degrees of that she's lacking in extension. So because she's lacking 65 degrees, we would call that negative 65 degrees of extension. And you will do that for all of her PIP joints to test for extension. Same thing for the DIP, except instead of putting it on the proximal, we put it on the middle and the distal. So middle, distal, axis on the DIP. We want to see how much she's lacking. So it's once again, it's supposed to be up here, but it's down here instead. So we're looking at 30 degrees she's lacking of extension here. Let me put that better, there we go. So maybe a little less than 30 degrees. So that would be considered, let's call it negative 25 degrees of extension.